Oh, that's wet. Oh, good afternoon. Actually, it's approaching evening. Now the hour will be 6 o'clock. As you know, I promised to do this, survival challenge with just the three items. Of course, I had to take a couple lights because, at night or whatever, you can't really see anything. I don't know if this is crooked or not. I have it on a rock. Okay. Might be a little bit better. Okay, yeah, that's better. Okay. As with all challenges, a lot of times there are things that happen that you don't foresee. And one of them was, well, if you see in front of you here, I have some birch bark. Birch bark will burn whether it's wet or dry. It has an oil in it called betulin. Okay. And this is something that our main character in The River and Hatchet and others would know. He would know that paper birch or white birch would burn to get a fire going. And that's what I'm going to attempt to do. It's going to be more difficult because when I was collecting that birch, I got stung by a wasp right on my thumb joint. So my thumb is swollen, it hurts, and it's hard to move. And so this is like a disability. The whole tip of my thumb from like here on up is like kind of numb, almost like if I had something wrapped on it. So instead of making a big shelter, I'm going to make a shelter that you would normally do in a situation where, you're in an emergency. I can't really use both hands. Well, I can, but this one's more difficult. I now have like a little bit of a handicap, and this is very real world. So in the first stage, I'm going to be making a fire. I got my birch bark and I got some twigs next to it. I'm going to get my, ferro cerium rod, as you guys voted on, and we're going to get this thing going. Because as you noticed, I got the birch bark, I got tiny, tiny twigs, I got some bigger ones. This is called layering the fire. You have to do it in layers. You just don't light a match on a log, so to speak. It won't burn. This one here, you have to go step by step, because fire, if you remember, is a triangle. It's heat, oxygen, and fuel. And for the fuel, for the heat, the small amount of heat that we have, there has to be enough air and there has to be enough surface area for it to ignite before it starts to catch. This really hurts. Boy, he got me good, because I stared at him saying, I hope it wasn't like a spider, but I knew what it was because it was just one puncture hole and it had to have been like a big yellow jacket or something. But my whole finger is like, my whole thumb is numb and it hurts. Ah, even to touch it. So anyways, let me go get my fire steel because it fell out of my pocket. That's why you need to be aware of all of these little things that you do. First things first, okay? What I'm gonna do, I wanna get a little pile of these scrapings, all right? I wanna get a little pile so that when I do ignite it, it's gonna go up in smoke, I hope. Oh, it did, but it didn't catch. Now, let's try some crumpled up leaves. It's dry enough for these to ignite. We're gonna have to do that again. It's never that easy, is it? I can feel the mosquitoes drilling into my skin right now. So I really wanna get this fire going as much as I can. Oh, I hate mosquitoes. See, there's an example of conflict. It's going to be a conflict of... Let's see, is that enough? We're going to find out very shortly. Nope. This is going to be a little more difficult than what I thought. Okay. I think I have to get a really big pile.
without igniting all of them. And that's the thing, I gotta have a little bit of patience. Seems like when I was a kid, I could do this a lot easier. Getting too soft. Oh, I didn't want to do that. I spilt a bunch of them. Looks like I gotta start it over again here. I think I'm going to take this thing right off. So it's like, I can't do what I have to do. Yeah, that hurts. There. Oh, yeah. Okay, nice move. Give it a shot. And it's still a no-go. What are we gonna do? This is not gonna be that easy. The old-fashioned one. No, that won't do it. Okay, I'm going to pause this.